Greetings to all. As the part of Moksha workshop, today I'm gonna show you a small recipe. I would like to call it aloo stuffed bread, and it's really crunchy and it can be used as a snack time recipe or a side dish to, you know, when your friends are coming over or anything like that. So let's get started. Okay, so I have taken the potatoes, I've boiled them, and so these are the potatoes, boiled potatoes, and now I've taken these masalas. So this is 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, then this is coriander powder, 1.5 teaspoon, and then this is you know, like fried coriander powder, like you fry the coriander and then you bring it to powder form. So this is again 2 teaspoon, and then this is chaat masala, 2 teaspoon, and this is cumin powder, 2 teaspoon, and then salt according to the taste. So now I'm gonna add all the masalas one by one. Yes, wait, stop, go. Yeah, so now I'm first going to mesh the potatoes. I have smashed the potatoes. I did it a little bit with the hand because it's hard to get them, you know, working well. So now I'm gonna add the masalas one by one, and then after adding them, I'm going to mix all of them again. So I have added the masalas, and again with my hand itself I'm going to mix them because hands work the best in case of, you know, dishes. So now I have finished mixing the masalas in the potato. Now I'm gonna add onion. I took like one this much sized onion, so let's add it and then mix it again. Yeah, so now I have mixed the masala with onions and all that, so this is our inner filling and it's ready. And now let's get to the outer covering. So I have cut like 5 pieces of bread. I've removed the extra outer parts. Now I'm gonna roll them with the help of this to, you know, make it like thinner and a little bit longer in size. So I'm gonna do it with all 5 of them so that they stick, you know, they become crunchier actually, because bread like this wouldn't stay that crunchy. So now when I have rolled the breads out, I'm gonna make small patties kind of thing with the potato. So let's make that. So I'm gonna take a handful according to how much I want in my bread and also how much fits into my bread. And yes, they look good enough. You need to make sure you take how much it fits into the bread, or else it's gonna fall out when you're gonna fry it. So we are gonna make patties. Okay, so now I've made the patties, and also one more paste. I've used a little bit maida, all-purpose flour, and water, like, yeah, water and maida to make this kind of a paste, so that helps us sticking the bread pieces when the patties are in. So we're gonna start. I'm gonna place it in the middle and with my finger, because that's the best way. Hands are the best way. So I have put this all around it, the paste, and you can just close it like this and then press it from the side so that there is no chance of opening them. Yeah, so I have done it a little bit this way, and we are going to do with the rest, go again with the rest and add maida and keep doing it. Just make sure the patties look like this one broke. Just make sure the patties aren't too big. I don't know what to do with this one, but yeah. Okay, so yeah, doing it. Just pressing on the sides a little bit harder so they stick to each other and they don't open in the frying pan, which has happened with me earlier a lot of times actually. And it's always best if you can take your mother's assistance in doing all this. Not this, but you know, taking the amount of masala that you need to put in. And that way, actually, you might have seen I've made a little bit extra masala. That's because I'm gonna make a little bit more afterwards for my friends coming over and all that. So okay, so I have made this one already actually, just to try it there. I have, you know, applied a little bit layer of egg on it and then the crumbs. These are bread crumbs. You can buy it, or else you can make it with the bread sides which you removed earlier. So I think the oil is hot enough, so let's get started. Yes, it is a little bit less hot right now. So meanwhile, the other one is boiling. You can apply the egg. You can just spread it around so the bread crumbs stick to it, which will make it crunchier. So you can do that. You can also dip it, you know, like the hole into the egg and then take it out, but I don't prefer that because it gets too slimy for me to do it. So I'm doing it with the brush. You can do it without the brush also. Then I'm going to keep it on the crumbs so that they stick. Then where they don't stick, I'm going to put it with my hand like this. And I'm going to repeat the same with all of them. So yes, this one looks crumb coated. Then don't forget to check on the other ones. You might burn them, so be careful about that also. So I'm going to keep it aside. Then do for the next one. You can take help if your mom in frying all this. Or your elder sister if you have one. I don't. I'm the eldest in my house. Eldest sibling actually. Eldest cousin also in my house. So okay, so this one is done from both the sides. The first one. Actually, I always go for frying with my mom, but today I tried it myself. So yes, let's get to it. They're gonna be really yummy, trust me. They're gonna be damn crunchy. The perfect snack for evenings also. And yeah, so I'm frying them, and then meanwhile they get fried from one side, I'm gonna prepare for the rest. Yeah, so these are the last two. Actually, in the starting you might have noticed I made a little bit more masala. So you can use the same aloo masala also when you're making pani puris. It can be great. So yeah, look at them. They are crunchy and good to go, and I am very excited to have them. Okay, so they are good to go, and I've made 6 of them now. Earlier there was only 5. So yes. Yeah, so now they have cooled enough, and I've served it for myself and my brother, and amazing and crunchy, and wow, you could savor it any time of the day. Even if I'm not, you know, hungry. So thank you for watching it, and I love doing it for you guys. So as you saw my dish, I hope you would like it and also try it, because they are really amazing, and I'm gonna go save them in and enjoy my snack time. I actually it's already late, so let's go do that. And I loved doing it for you guys. Thank you so much.
Namaste to all. My name is Rishika. So today I'm going to be talking about the slave dynasty. The Turkish slaves. In the 10th century, there were Turkish tribals and they were highly trained in military arts. So by the 9th to the 13th century, they came into the courts of medieval kings and they ultimately rose into high ranks. And they were also highly trained in archery and horsemanship. So first, they were bought from Transoxania and then to Ghazni and then was purchased by the ruler, Sultan, in Delhi. Archery and horsemanship. So this is how they were trained in archery and horsemanship. So, and these were also the weapons which were used. So this is Muhammad Ghori, who was from the Ghurid Empire, and Qutbuddin Aibak. So four Mamluks rose to high command: Yildiz in Afghan mountains, Kubacha in Indus, and Bakhtiar in Bengal, and also Aibak at Delhi. So I'm going to be talking about Qutbuddin Aibak from 1206 to 1210. He was one among the Turkish slaves. But he was well educated by his owner and the chief of Qadi of Nishapur. So while he grew up, he was purchased by Muhammad Ghori. Aibak's career was divided into three phases. He was in charge of North India. Then he was the Malik and Sipar Salar of Delhi and Lahore. So Delhi will come here. And Lahore over here. And he was the head of an official independent ruler in India. Aibak was one of the general of Ghurid army at the first battle of Terrain, and in the second battle of Terrain he fought with Prithviraj III along with Muhammad Ghori. And in the second battle of Terrain they defeated Prithviraj III. And along with Muhammad Ghori, Aibak, he took control over the Chahamana area, which is over here, Chahamanas. And Aibak marched to Ranthambore. He took control over Ranthambore, which is over here, near Delhi. And he also took control over Hansi, which is here. And then he took control over Meerut and Varan. So these were the areas which he took control over with Muhammad Ghori: Chalukya, Chahamanas, Tumara, Gandhawalas, and Chandelas. He took control over Delhi in 1192, where he retained the local Tumara rulers as vassals. And in 1193, he deposed the Tumara rulers and took control over Delhi. After that, he stayed in Ghazni for about 6 months, and then he returned to India in 1194, where he crossed Yamuna and he captured Koyal. In 1197, Aibak defeated Chalukya army, and then in 1197 to 98, Aibak conquered Badaun, present day that is Uttar Pradesh, and also Gandhawalas. And in 1102, Aibak built an important fort in the Chandela kingdom. He took an important fort in the Chandela kingdom of central India. So after the Sultan died, Aibak had his headquarters at Delhi, and he consolidated his rule in the territories even which was in his control already. But later in 1210, he fell down from a horse while he was playing the polo. And this is the family tree of Qutbuddin Aibak. Aram Shah is the son of Aibak. He ascended his throne, but he was then killed by Iltutmish in 1211 AD. Shamsuddin Iltutmish. Shamsuddin Iltutmish was the third Mamluk ruler, and he was also a Turkish slave, but later he was then made as the Sultan of Delhi. First, Iltutmish was taken from Transoxania, and then he was brought to Ghazni, and later he was purchased by Aibak in Delhi. Iltutmish, he was appointed as the governor of Badaun, and he, as Aibak died, as Qutbuddin Aibak died, Iltutmish claimed the throne in Delhi. As I told before, he killed Aram Shah. So, four Mamluks rose to high command: Yildiz in Afghan mountains, Kubja on the Indus, Bakhtiar in Bengal, and Aibak at Delhi. So, Iltutmish, he defeated Yildiz in AD 1215. So, this is just a timeline. So, he defeated Yildiz in AD 1215 in the Battle of Terrain. And later in 1217, he drove Kabacha from Lahore. And later in 1220, he saved the Sultan from destruction by the Mongol under Chinggis Khan. And then 1226 to 1227, Bengal and Bihar was back into the Delhi Sultan. Later in 1226, he captured Ranthambore. And 1231, he captured Jalore, Bayana, and Gwalior. So this was the area that was in Iltutmish's rule. This full area was in Iltutmish's reign. In 1236, Iltutmish fell ill while he was marching towards Quarrel's stronghold of Bamiyan, and then he returned to Delhi on 20 April, and later he died on 1236. Qutub Minar. So this is the Qutub Minar complex. This is Qutub Minar, and here is a few mosques. And also Alauddin Khilji's extension to the mosque, and here the Qutbuddin Aibak's tomb is there. Qutub Minar is 72.5 meters high and is one of the tallest minaret in the world built of bricks. So Qutbuddin Aibak, he first started the construction, and he just built the first story in 1199. And later, Aibak's successor, Iltutmish, he completed the further three stories. And then it was destroyed by Ruknuddin Firoz. So, Firoz Shah Tughlaq, he replaced the damage which was done by Ruknuddin Firoz. And Sher Shah Suri added an entrance to this tower. The Quwat Islam is known as the Might of Islam, and is the first mosque which is built in Delhi, and the remnant of and had remnants of 27 Jain temples that were demolished, and the pillars were taken with them. And also the mosque was extended after Aibak's death by Iltutmish in 1230. So Qutub Minar, the first story was in alternate wedge shaped, and then the second story was in circular, the third one was in the star shaped, and the fourth one was in like a round shape. So the first three stories were made of red sandstone, and then the fourth and the fifth story was made by marble and sandstone. Alai Darwaza. Alai Darwaza is a main gateway from the southern side of Quwat ul-Islam Mosque, and is one of the most important building built in the Delhi Sultan period. The Iron Pillar, it's like 7.21 meters high and weighs more than 6 tons, and was from Chandragupta II, which was in front of the Vikramaditya Vishnu Temple. And this was later shifted to Anangpal, and then from there to Udayanagar to the present location. Tomb of Iltutmish. Iltutmish, the third ruler of Delhi, built 1235 CE, is also part of Qutub Minar complex. The tomb of Iltutmish is a part of Qutub Minar complex. So during the excavation, they found out that the burial of Iltutmish was 20 steps away from the tomb. Ruknuddin Firoz, Iltutmish's successor, he ruled for like less than 7 months in 1236. He was not like much of a good ruler because he just wanted pleasure, and he left his mother Shah Turkan in control of the administration. But due to the misadministration, there were rebellions. So the nobles and the army, they finally appointed his half-sister, Razi, on the throne. And Ruknuddin Firoz, he ruled, he administered Lahore and Badaun. Razia, she is notable because she was the first female Muslim ruler in the Indian subcontinent. And she has administrated Delhi when her father was busy in Gwalior campaign. She was deposed by a group of nobles in April 1240, and she married a rebel, Altunia, but his half-brother, Muizzuddin Bahram, killed both of them. So this is Razia Sultan, and she administered Delhi. So this is a movie of Razia Sultan, and this is a serial, period drama serial of Razia Sultan. So Muizzuddin Bahram was the sixth sultan of the Mamluk dynasty. He killed his sister in order to come into the throne of Delhi and become the sultan. And he was the son of Iltutmish. And Bahram's 2 years as king, he just ruled for 2 years as a king. But during this period, he was murdered by his own army, and later he was succeeded by his nephew, Alauddin Masoud. Alauddin Masoud was the son of Ruknuddin Firoz and the grandson of Iltutmish, but he was infamous. He just wanted entertainment and wine, just like his father Ruknuddin Firoz. But because the chiefs all became upset because he was worthless and incomplete, so they declared Nisaruddin Mahmud as the next king. Nasir Uddin Mahmud was the grandson of Iltutmish and was the 8th sultan, but he came into throne in a tender age at 17 or 18, but he spent most of the time in prayer and copying the Quran. He was very religious. So he left Ghiyath-ud-Din Balban to deal with his state affairs. Ghiyath-ud-Din Balban succeeded him after him, and he was a 9th Sultan ruler. When he was young, he was captured from the Mongols and he was taken to Ghazni. Ghazni is over here. And sold to Khawaja Jamal Uddin of Basara and a Sufi. And later he was brought to Delhi and was purchased by Iltutmish. His conquest, he had control over areas around Mewat, and he reconquered Bengal. And all while he was not successful with the Mongols, but due to this threat of the Mongols, he was not successful. Neither he also lost his son during this struggle. So at that time, in his last days, he was actually in an unrecoverable shock because his son Muhammad, as I mentioned before in the before slide, he died in the hands of Mongols. So he was in an unrecoverable state of shock. So in his last days, he asked his son Bughra Khan, who was the governor of Bengal, to stay with him, but he slipped away. And eventually Balban chose his grandson Muizzuddin Kabab. Muizzuddin Kalkabad. So he was the 10th Sultan of Mamluk dynasty, and he was the son of Bughra Khan, an independent ruler of Bengal. So after the Mamluk dynasty, as he was still young, after 4 years, he suffered from a paralytic stroke, and later he was murdered by the Khalji dynasty. Thank you and have a happy learning.
Have anything to ask? If I ask you 10 questions to prepare, you will prepare 10 questions. If I ask you to comment, you will comment. If I ask you to do an assignment, you will do it. You are digitally unfit in this world. Most of you, I am not saying you means not the people who are presenting here. This video will go, so I want this message to go others who are not even present. Yeah.
So how is rainfall measured?
How is rainfall
measured?
Yeah, it's a beautiful question. Keep 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter dabba. Okay, 1 meter by 1 meter and 1 meter height also. And then keep it in the place where you want to measure the rain.
Okay.
If it is filling 70 centimeter, you say 70 centimeter rain is there.
Okay.
But 70 centimeter rain you will get only in Kerala. 30 centimeter itself is too big. Yeah. Nitish, the other day you appeared with a sleeveless banyan and all that. And so much of disturbance on video. Don't do that. It shows your culture. It shows your way of life.
Okay, sir. It's forgot.
Not forgot. That has to be your... No?
Yes,
no, today you are good. Looking good. So, as a human being, we are supposed to do so many things. And if you don't do it, Vidada has nothing to do with that. Vidada is what you call it as fate. The fate is not there, it is within you only. You decide what is your fate. So what is within you which makes you to be creative is what is called your own fate. But some people for escapism, we keep mentioning God controls us. There is nothing God with outside, it is inside only. I told many times this. Hridaya guhara madhye kevalam brahma matram. Inside our hridayam, we are there, that's it. And that, when you realize, that becomes God for you. All of your activities and all were good. Wonderful. If you are not doing it regularly and you are just showing, that is not good. It should be your regular activity.
Sir, I have a question. I'm Rida from Rasul Khaimah.
Yeah.
Sir, in one of your videos, you told that mind and body are related, but there are some people who physically not fit, but they're talented, like Stephen Hawking. So how does that happen?
Mind is not brilliance or what and how do you do your research or in physics or maths. English and original meaning of the word what you use in English do not correlate very well. Mind is manas. The same video I must have told manas. Manas is what reflects in your happiness. Manas is what makes you to be active. Manas is what controls your indriyas. So indriyas can be inactive. That means your intellect is still active. Your manas is like a software. Intellect is like a hardware. The memory inside your computer is intellect. He has got lot of capacity to keep the data there. Okay, the software is what the manas is. Manas is what makes the indriyas to react to situations. Sharira manaso yoga paraspara manuvrajet. The body and the mind is such related. Assume you have severe headache, probably you will not smile. But your manas is always gloomy, you will always show gloomy face. The manas is concretized by the people around you. I told this at least sometime, I think, in some places. You cannot go to a place when somebody died and then you cannot keep laughing there. So the environment controls your manas. When you keep on crying for some time, definitely you will feel upset. Assume you don't like me talking to you, you will show a gloomy face. So your face is a physical face which you are showing. But if your manas is happy, definitely you will show a smiling face. You cannot have a manas unhappy and showing a smiling face. But some people are created. Their bhavam itself is always like that. Though maybe they are too much kanjus, reserved inside. They don't want to show their happiness. Got it? See, what is that stopping you? Why do you want to be so conjuice in talking? Priya vakya pradanena sarve tushyantu jantavaha. Nice words are told, everybody is happy. Tasma tateka vaktavyam vajaneka daridrata. Then why can't you speak good words? Why do you want to become conjuice in using words? I may scold Akash. That is just because I will give an assignment, immediately he will ask something else which is not at all related to that. I have given assignments to all of you and immediately there, see, I said Monday we will meet. Nobody asked a question. Nobody means generally. There are few people who asked, sir, why today there is no meet. Somebody doesn't bother. So you are all like rubbish kids, not your problem. Your parents made you like that. Unless it is given, you will not take it. Assume your parents don't call you for breakfast, you will sleep as much as you can. And when you wake up immediately, I want to eat. That's it. You don't care who is. See, when you make a video, if you say that, you know how the character is analyzed. When you make a video, you say that I am helping my mother. That means the whole job is mother's, you are helping. You don't take it as your activity. The word which you use also I analyze to understand your character. So each word what you use determines your basic style. We know people by looking at them, how lazy you are. Are you really working it or showing that you are working?
So I'm Dina from Mysore.
Good girl. That is how you should speak. Yeah.
So you mentioned that you do Himalayan meditation. So how is a Himalayan meditation different from normal meditation and how do you perform?
But see, I told you all the time, whenever Dr. TPS talks about something, if you have anything to know from that, type that word and my name. Meditation, Dr. TPS. You will see a clipping of 20 minutes wherein I am teaching meditation to somebody else and this is what is Himalayan meditation. That's it. Actually, I don't teach meditation. I don't do meditation. When I am talking to you now, I am meditating. Meditation is not closing your eyes and then sleeping there and all that is rubbish, foolish, cheating people. Meditation is Samadhi. Samadhi means your brain doesn't work. It doesn't mean you died. Your brain is dead. That means electroencephalograph doesn't have vibration. You are in full happy mood. You are not taxing your brain. That's why I can give lectures hours together. 48 hours continuously I gave lecture. I don't mind how many of you suffer now. But I enjoy. So when I do that, I am not taxing my brain. So if I am not taxing my brain to reach that situation, before that I need to get into dhyana. And reaching up to the dhyana, somebody can be guided through. So yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana. Dhyana is concentration. Dharana is focusing on something. And then samadhi. Samadhi you reach. But because of samadhi, there is, people mistake it as death. When you translate it to English, it became meditation. People don't have dhyana as a translatory program which is in English style. Therefore, everybody clubbed together using it as meditation. I teach meditation, I learn meditation. That's why I also kept Dr. TPS meditation. Actually, it is not a meditation. That I explain somewhere, if you type in, you will learn yoga. I don't believe in meditation. I don't have meditation. Somebody who pretends that they are doing dhyana and meditation are all foolish, wasting their time. Doing the same Hare Rama, Hare Krishna 100 times is wasting your time. Without even knowing, they will keep on chanting. That is not dhyanam. Dhyanam is silence. Silence is when you can look into yourself. When you look into yourself and you are not outside at all, that is inner self, you get a realization. That realization should come in you where you feel so happy, bliss. That blissful, all of you show your smiling face. Why are you so serious? Am I scolding you or I am telling something which is not at all going into your brain? Learn to smile. Don't go to that, always a moody face like this. It looks so stupid and rubbish, no? If you are in front of me, I will slap you, that's it. Why? I don't understand at all. Why? What is that? You know, so you are so beautiful when you smile. And if you don't smile, you look so ugly. Nobody in this world likes somebody who is crying. Somebody is showing ugly face. Aparna, smile. Show others how to smile. She just woke up. That's a problem.
No, sir.
Okay.
Nothing as such.
Yeah. What you should do is, that happiness is called bliss. But I have seen meditating people like very serious. You cannot have a meditation in seriousness. Meditation is always blissfulness. Bliss is happy. When you are happy inside, definitely you are happy outside also. And you cannot tell I am meditating for 5 minutes. Because when you meditate, the time tag is lost. You cannot see the watch and say, yeah, let it be 5 minutes, then I will stop meditating. So most of this show what you see are not correct. So my meditation process where I teach, generally I have a camp in Tnanam, Kerala. When people come, I very rarely teach dhyanam, layam, getting merged into that. I'll tell them we have got a upstairs, second floor in my house. We have got a huge hall where meditation place. That's what we say, meditation place. That is just for people to understand. That's where you can sit and then see the environment around. So no disturbance. I asked my students who are participating, maybe 10 or 15 of them, go and sit there for some time. When you are in silence, I will come and teach you the different steps in meditation. I stay in the ground floor to listen what are they doing. They keep on talking. Finished. I don't go there at all. They will wait some time and after some time somebody will come. I said no meditation today. Because I asked you to prepare yourself. What is preparation for meditation? Silence. You want to talk many things, then that is not a place where you cannot do. So it is a self-discipline. That self-discipline is not there, you cannot learn. So what is meditation? Silence. But in silence also, you talk to yourself many times. You are looking at something, then you are imagining the shape, size, color, You keep creating your own creativity around it. All that keeps happening. Can you stop this? That is called dharana. For which you will have to divert your attention. Probably it will not come straight. So diverting attention can be concentrating on a god, concentrating on some book, concentrating some good saying, concentrating in music, concentrating in your guru, concentrating, so many things can be there. Then when you concentrate there, that becomes dhyanam. That dhyanam should come from within. I cannot make Diya to concentrate on something. I can only ask you to concentrate here. But you will be concentrating somewhere else, 100% sure, some that time also. Because I am asking you to concentrate in your breath. I am telling you are looking at me and concentrating on me, but not on your breath. Because if you are listening that I am asking you to concentrate, where are you concentrating? On my words. So no guided meditation is possible. Guiding in meditation is a stupid thing. Because guiding is, I can guide you only when you concentrate on me. What is meditation? Concentrating inside you. So how can I guide you in meditation? So Himalayan meditation believes silence. Himalayan meditation equals silence. My guru taught only one thing in his life. My meditation master Swami Vedabharati. What did he teach? Only silence. That's a big lesson. Very difficult to teach somebody silence. Not silence externally. Tongue movement is stopping. No, that is not silence. Internally be silent. And internally silent means you should not become violent. But violent doesn't mean I will not scold Akash. I will scold Akash. But while scolding Akash also, my heartbeat is not changing. I am calm. Immediately I can look at Aparna and smile. Because I am not agitated. You understood the difference? So you can be calm, but externally you can be showing that you are angry. That is to teach a lesson. If I tell slowly also people don't listen, you will have to shout. You cannot ask a dog, get out of the place, get out of the place, get out of the place. Dog will not go. I have to say, get out. Then immediately the dog will go. It is not because dog understand the English grammar and all that. Got it? You ask the dog come in, it will come in. Because you are also showing a signal with your hand. Some people understand only that. Some people are like that. They don't understand words. They understand only signals like dogs. So therefore you will have to shout. You will have to show hands. Then it will work. So that stage you go, you concentrate on the inside. What is happening around, I don't care. That is what is meditation. So listen to my 20 minutes of meditation. You can see there, that's a video, because audio is not that popularly circulated. YouTube is easily circulated. So I put a YouTube there. But you can have a glance through that, but then concentrate on that. Actually, I will ask people to lie down on their tummy. We are all taking breath, but we don't know that we are taking breath. We are not aware of it. Being aware of your breath itself is controlling breath. Being aware of being sleep is controlling sleep. Being aware of your learning is controlling learning. Being aware that you are not learning is actually a learning process. That's how you get into that. So I am making people to realize how to take breath by concentrating on your breath. Breath control automatically controls your manas. Because when you get angry, your breathing rate will change. Normally that is what will happen. That is why I said Sharira Manaso Yoga. Angry is a mood of the manas. Breathing is a physical activity. Both are related. So you can control the body. Through that you can control manas. Control the manas through body. Both are possible. So that is the meditation style which I teach. Actually it is not meditation at all. It is the breathing practice. Pranayama. But I don't teach pranayama. In my style, my breathing. In your style you can breathe. Everybody has got their own style. So I should not impose my style on somebody else. Have you seen young children when they lie down, their tummy goes up and down? So you don't feel it now because you don't concentrate or your tummy become too big. So what is to be done? Lie down upside down. So your belly is on the ground or bed. When you breathe, you keep feeling that it is going up and down. That means your concentration on the airflow inside your body. Automatically your pranayama will happen. That's it. Don't follow like some swamijis who are mentally bad and they start selling meditation. Right? They sell meditation by teaching breathing practice, one nose, another nose, and all that. God has created two nose to take breath, two nose parallel. But one Swami cannot decide you have to take only with one nose. And they will say you take breath through left nose, it goes to the right brain, right through, as if there is a tunnel created inside. They don't even understand the basic anatomy, they did not understand the basic chemistry, biochemistry. They are all marketing personnel. So don't get into such the so-called learning meditation from stupid fellows unless that is theoretically explained and you get convinced asking a lot of questions by yourself. Yeah, but still you have not come to my
question. Sir, I plan for doing travel blog. So, sir, is it possible if anyone living in UAE can do show any attractions in a place where they live in so they can do a group activity with me?
Let me again.
Sir, is it possible for anyone to do a travel blog living in UAE, about one of the attractions in UAE?
You want to do a travel
blog about I'm in Ras Al Khaimah, so I have a fort here, historic fort. So I'm going to be talking about that.
Okay.
So, sir, if anyone living in UAE can do a travel blog about an attraction in their emirate.
How does it become a group activity?
Sir, because we are doing the same thing and people will get to know about the things that is happening in UAE, the attractions in UAE. Is it possible, sir?
It is possible, but I don't think this is the right time to go out and then do such things. People are asked to not to mix too much, go there physical and all that. Okay, stay stable. Yeah.
So, Trishika from Abu Dhabi.
Yeah.
So why do Swami go to Himalaya to eat?
Their electromagnetic energy has got a different density, therefore higher potential of energy is possible and oxygen content is less, so your breathing rate will change. And that is traditionally the place of gods. Godson Valley is there. Yeah, still you have not come to. Rida started that discussion on activity. But, yeah. This is what the problem with the children. You take your teacher, you take your parents, are all useless for you. You don't consider them. You take it for granted. You don't look at them, you don't cheer them, because they may tell you this is not right, this is not the way to do. If they don't tell you, who else will tell you? You have not been trained properly, that's a problem. And your parents keep on telling you same thing many times. So if unless somebody tells you many times, you don't even do it. That is why I also have to tell you like this, which is not my general practice. I will tell only once. If you listen, you listen. That's it. But same person will keep on doing same thing. How can I stop? I can just throw you. But that is not correct. So will you be able to get some creative activity where you are not thinking, you are not participative, you don't have time for this? That's a different matter. But I have got wonderful creative ideas. where each one of you will do different things at different places. Make a real beautiful story around it. Rida, individually you may be good, but that show is done. So somebody should think, yeah, I want Rida in my group. I want Aparna in my group. Where is this Meenakshi, Raju, Pallavi and all? They went for brushing or what? Nitish anyway has just got up now. Sion always have some problem.
Sir, my... Sir, my video is on.
Do you think you can create something?
Yes, sir.
But then don't ask me when should I give you and all that. That's why I said first come first served basis. Because if somebody creates a story and say that this is what the people I want, then I'll tell you take them, finished. Then the rest of the people lose their chance. So let me see whether you can do it or not. You understood what I'm looking for? Is there any doubt on this? We have done beautiful drama when Harini attended at Nanam camp. I don't know how many of you have seen. Look at Dr. TPS Harini Nanam. You will see Harini becoming a bride. And then we had a dance around them. We just create. We don't even give time. I don't know what I am going to do next moment. That's how I do my programs. And he got married. Harini got married that day. Probably the best smile in her life I have seen only that time. After that she never smiled. Because probably she got divorced after that. Coming back from Nanam. Always she is in that mood only. Thinking about the golden days. You have. See, I became an actor when I was in 7th class. So creating dramas is instantaneous for me. Yesterday my MSc classmate called me. MSc is when? 1986. What a 26 years back, my classmate called Dr. Lakshmi. She is a doctorate in statistics. When she was studying MSc mathematics with me in my class, she was doing MSc statistics. We had a combined class. When she joined for MSc, she had a child who was studying for 10th class. She took a break of long years and then joined for MSc after BSc. Her husband was a doctor, medical doctor, practicing very well in Cochin. So when we had an annual meet, there was a proposal, we have to make some drama. We are all mathematics and statistics student. We don't have time. Every day examination, assignments, internal exam, very busy, 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 busy. But this Lakshmi being an old lady, who was my classmate, she said, we want to make a drama. I said, let me think something. But then the last date was next day afternoon to submit the proposal in the university. Night, we don't even have a cell phone, smartphone and all that day. So she telephoned to me at night from the hostel. Then she said, is the drama story ready? That was after my dinner, maybe 8 o'clock or 8:30, 9 o'clock. I never thought about this at all. Just to satisfy her, I said, we will do something and then forgot about it. But then having she telephoned, I said, yeah, you write down your dialogue. This is your dialogue. By heart and come tomorrow. We will by heart it here. Virtually like you, we have done it. We were not done any rehearsal straight away. What we did was, I kept on dictating. She wrote down everything. Next day morning, 9 o'clock in the class, she said, I by heart at everything. And I asked her, you must get some telescope and all that. That's the only equipment which she can get because her husband is a doctor. After telling this, I slept. I don't even remember what dialogue I gave. No drama in the mind also. Everything forgotten. We have not practiced. No people together had. We didn't have even 2-3 people to act in that drama. But I have a concept in my mind, her part I told, that's it. And we have morning 9 o'clock class. 12 o'clock is the lunch break. In next 2 days, we have to put it in the university platform. A highly creative drama I created. I am the director, I am the story writer, I am a blind man in the drama. Another character is a deaf and dumb. So no dialogue to be by heart. Somebody said, sir, I cannot by heart dialogue at all. I said, don't worry, you are a dumb and fellow, so you don't have to by heart. The whole scene is in a hospital. So doctors will have always a case chart. Some paper with them, right? Yes or no? And
yes,
that paper contains all the dialogues. The doctor can look at it, nurse can look at it. So two people need not by heart. And I am a blind person, I am the director. Who has to speak when that sequence is with me? So I will go and touch somebody, that person will have the dialogue. So on the stage, direction happened, we got first prize. You understood? So I am a highly creative person. I can just write. I can just make all of you to act. I am not trying to make you that. I want you to think. We have a great artist here. There are so many people who are artistic, who can do wonders. Great acting they can do. You should also have that ability to write and tell me, this is what we want. The other day, I'll tell you, in my family group, Dr. TPS, MCK, family, they created a beautiful cinema. Where my cousins are all acting in different houses. I don't know how many of you have seen. Anyone has seen that?
Yes, sir.
Which is that?
Yeah. Sir, it was in the beginning. Sir,
about new things.
Drama.
Yeah. See, high creative, no? I remember those children who are all my cousin's children. My cousin is Revi, Unni, Gauri, and all these people. They are the parents of these children. When we were young, like your age, I used to go to their house and we used to have drama together. So it's all in the blood. We used to play drama. All our vacation used to be with the drama. Yeah, Sanvi. Come out with something.
Sir, I had a plan that I can be a doctor and there can be a patient, but for I am not able to treat the patient because all the medical equipments and things I'm giving her, she's not responding to that. So maybe a person who can sing well, when she sings a song, the patient starts to recover and...
So who is the singer you want? Who is the patient you want? Who looks like a patient here? And who looks like a singer? With your experience of seeing different. This is why I said you must all watch videos. You must analyze people. All that what I said. This is for this purpose. And you will have some assignment coming forward before making the group. That also I'll tell you. After that only the group will be made. Yeah. Tell me, whom do you want, Rida?
Sir, Pallavi.
Pallavi as a patient?
No, sir. Sir,
okay. Okay. Who is the patient whom you do you want? Who do you think is a big patient here? Mental patient? Who is not responding to any answers, any questions? Yeah, suggest. See, this screen is auto set. I am not setting who has to come where. So now I am seeing three boys here, Akash, Sion and Jayakrishnan. In each one of you, your screen will be different. Eh? So they are the left side people whom I have. Rida is in the next column, first. Then Sujan. Sujan is another boy. He is not appearing anyway. Then Meenakshi Raju, she disappeared. She left always flower for us. A flowery day. Sanvi, come up. She is from Muscat, Sanvi. She is a great artist. She does a lot of things. The Sujan has come without combing hair anyway. Or that is the style probably. Careful carelessness. Then I have Neelima, Pallavi and another Nitish. Who is not appearing in at all. Then I have Harini on the top left, right top corner. Aparna is below that and my Mysore Diya is, Mysore Pak is there on the bottom top, right bottom. Yeah. Aparna's dosha was good, yeah. Had a good taste. I, when we, what did you like of Aparna's dosha? Anybody? Fast comment.
It had
different. Eh?
It had different
shape and the color.
Yeah, I remember when our BSc classmates met, were meeting, we had our group photo printed on a cake. You know that edible printing is possible, right? Yeah, yes. Then you know what people did. I don't like this teacher, let me eat their head because she ate my head long. Some student was cutting and then eating the teacher. No. Somebody said, this girl is so sweet, let me eat it. That girl. Yeah. Come on. Tell Rida, you don't want character?
Yes, sir, I want it.
Only you want Pallavi, that's it.
No, sir, the patient.
Huh.
Sir, anyone can come?
No. Nobody would like to volunteer to be a patient in this world. Unless you give a beautiful role in that and then become a, highly, a great character at the end of the story at least. Don't make them to die, but make them to be happy, right? Because that's what you are doing. So Pallavi's girlfriend or boyfriend? Because when Pallavi sings only, doctor is immaterial. So you are showing actually the situation, what is around you. The peer groups can influence more, not even doctors, teachers, parents. Pallavi, whom do you want to influence? Rida and Pallavi can decide together. Okay, you.
I think.
Who? Harini feels Harini is the patient. Then?
So I think I might be the patient.
Okay, Rida, now you want to tell or you want to leave it?
Sir, I chose Akash. I sent it to you. What's up?
Pallavi, do you think you can sing and wake him up?
I will try, sir.
There is no try word in my life. One word which I don't like is try. Better than song sometime, pouring lot of water will help. You know, there is a great... Do you know Dr. TPS really? I can sing and make it rain. Do you know that? Eh?
No, sir.
Yeah, I can sing and make it rain. Harini also don't know, right? Yeah. I am a great singer. I can sing and make it rain. You know how? I will sing. I will sing until it rains. Then I can say what? Then what I can say?
Sir, or you can, sir, when you start singing, sir, you can just pour water, sir.
That is yours. I said rain. Water is different and rain is different. That's the difference between something and everything and many things. That confusion you have. So you know what does it mean? The word what I said has got a great meaning. If you are not able to do something, prolong doing it. That's an indirect meaning. See, just because of this discussion, I am making a general quote statement. This is how I become creative. When I discuss something, I become creative. Diya, I can sing from here and I can give rain in Mysore. When you get rain, you telephone and tell me. Then I will say, from today I was singing until it was raining in Mysore. But I cannot do it in Ras Al Khaimah. No guarantee. I will have to sing for one full year also, it may not come.
After 3 months it will rain.
So yeah, then I will start singing in October.
Can vaccines be added to other groups' acts, like for Veda's act before?
Oh, you want one more patient, another bed. Harini wanted to be a patient anyway.
No, I mean like vaccines, like before the person comes to the hospital or something like that, to start the interview.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You want any robot help? Any video game to make Akash agitated? Our Sian is there. Sian will come with a robotic game and try. At the last can be the music. Everybody can try. Maybe Aparna can come with some dosha and then prompt, because Akash likes eating anyway. And try. Come please, get up. This is to hit. Jayakrishnan can make a nice tea with a good smell. Hmm? Tell. Kya diya?
Well, there can be a big disease that's happening similar to coronavirus, and that's what it affected. So we are trying to find out the vaccine. So Harini can be the scientist. So she was about to she will find the vaccine for it.
Okay.
It could be like we are trying, and then we, after Pallavi starts singing, we find out that no vaccine is required, and singing is the remedy for the problem.
Yeah, any more addition from Mysore?
Sir, I have a different plan. Like I was thinking of doing an advertisement about a paint bomb kind of thing with different scenes. Different people are like experiencing pain. And one person comes and be like, this is a, like you can use this for any pain relief. Like that. So different scenes, for example, in a scene a kid is hurt. Then he comes home crying, and the mother, he's like, it's okay, I'll put you this balm, you'll be okay within 10 minutes. Then the phone is the mother getting overworked, and she has a headache, and after applying the balm, her headache goes.
Okay.
So something.
So who is the kid, who is the mother you want in your group?
So it's like how, like when we all meet after 15 years, we all have, so like some of them can be doctors, so we can include Lipa C, where she talks about her story, and Pallavi can be a singer like that.
Then the whole thing will become only one act, right?
So, do you know what others are going to be?
So, they can decide like what they do.
But then the dialogue should come, no? Otherwise, meeting will not happen, no? Okay. Now let me. Okay, we will work on that. What Rishika said, we can work. But now, who had an idea? Diya left. The pain. Where is the pain girl? She left. Aparna, wake up, wake up. No, you are muted, beta.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, wake up, I said. Yeah, Diya, what do you say? What do you say?
Can I message you
the
Instagram?
Yeah, fine.
Decided.
Fine, yeah.
So, sir, actually my school, like I have English class going on right now, so...
Okay, fine, bye. Yeah, go ahead.
Bye, thank you.
See, the students from India like Diya and Sujan, we have Karti, we had so many other children, BSc students and all that, they all have online classes, so they're all busy. So basically, this was made for the Gulf students like you. It all started because Harini's father told me that, you know, she has holidays tomorrow. That is how I thought immediately I should do it. Yeah. Tell me, Aparna, fast. Sanvi. Sanvi is hidden. Yeah, Neelima. Rishika, tell me. Pallavi left. When you asked to sing, she left. Finished?
As Rishika said, it could be like we are meeting after a few years, and then she asked Rida about how everything has been and if she met any of us before that day. And that's what she tells about the hospital story. Like,
no, don't mix. We need at least one or two different things. You are a patient now. If you want a bi-patient, you can be a bi-patient. Okay. Otherwise, don't add Rida and Anish and Pallavi. You decide with somebody else. You can discuss with Aparna or maybe Sian, and then
yeah,
that discussion can go on. That these 3-4 people are meeting because you suggested. I'm saying. Whom do you want? Other than now, leave Rida, Pallavi, Akash. They are in a role play. Rida, if ready to leave this scientist, then she can be part of something else. Otherwise, now we know Rida is a doctor, Pallavi is a singer, Akash is a patient, Harini is a scientist, we know. Now, Rishika can collect the somebody else. Whom do you want to discuss? You can have only one or two people, otherwise it becomes too clumsy. So you discuss about all the other people.
Can I send them?
Yeah, you can send. Whom do you want? Yeah. Karthi has any idea?
No, sir, I will text you after something.
Okay, and when I send a text, it takes 1 day or 2 days. When I call, you will say, I will text you. This is how you escape in your classrooms. Don't do that. It's fine. Yeah, Sian, you want to add something? Akash, Jay Krishnan. There are some people like Sri Lakshmi from Kerala and all is very active, but Kerala is heavy rain. She is stuck in Kottayam. So that area, once heavy rain comes, no electricity also. Kerala, many of the places, there is a big problem. No electricity, no telephone will work. It's heavy rain. She and all will connect me after some time and then say that, no, I missed this. And other day, her father, he is a principal in Kuwait, who took me to Kuwait. My Kuwait trip was a fantastic trip. Jay Krishnan was there. I don't know whether he knows me during my...
No, sir.
Yeah.
No, sir, I was not there.
Yeah. I was in 17 different schools. Every day, and that was all teachers training program. Except in one school, 16 schools were teachers training. So I go to one school, that school is holiday that day. Because all teachers have to attend my class. So I am the only one person in Kuwait gave different holidays for different schools. The whole history of Kuwait and the schools in CBSE. Even king dies one day only holiday. But that day, then some parent called me and said that, no, this day you are coming to my school. I said, how do you know? No, my children have holidays there because you are going there. So I taught almost all the Indian school teachers in Kuwait. Next week I have in Doha a teacher's training program. Yesterday and day before yesterday, I talked on Indian scientific heritage on a Sanskrit day before yesterday. So, Sri Lakshmi's father telephoned and then we had almost a 1 hour discussion. You remember Sri Lakshmi, right? Who was sweeping the road also. Road is private road, it is not a government road. That road must be reaching her house only. Exclusive road. Because Kerala, it's like that in the villages. The road ends in your house. Yeah.
Sir, can I have an hybrid?
Who?
Aparna and? Harini
must get your leaving order from Rida now.
Yes, sir, it's fine.
Okay. So, Harini, is it okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Neelima, Harini, and Aparna. Aparna, is it okay to have these two girls around you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't sweep them off. Rida is also, Rishika is also a good sweeper. Done?
Sir, how many minutes should be the drama be?
You can decide. We don't have... I know, I am sure you are not going to make it for 1 hour anyway, right? Yeah, don't worry. But then you have a nice script. It looks like a dialogue between you together. And then action should come. Write the script perfectly well, when to start, when to stop. All that can be discussed. Probably you can have a trial audio in case if you want in between in that group. All that can happen. Okay? Yeah. It's good enough? Bye then.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.